March 28th here. I just made a paper pattern for what I want to build for the gauge holder on the dash. And I set this up there and got it to fit real nice. It's just a piece of paper that I cut out and used for, like I said, for the pattern. And this is the metal gauge holder I'm building in the place of the pattern. I'll fill in the ends on both sides and have it so this can come off easily from a bracket that I attached to this. But look at those angled gauges, aren't they neat? They're gonna face the driver. So you really be careful with them so I don't drop them, but that's kind of the setup there. It's gonna fit on the dash really well. So I just wanted to show preliminary stages here. I'm gonna build some ends for this bracket now on each end and weld them in. And then I'll go from there for supporting it, and also have a passageway for wiring to come into it. So we'll see how it goes here, where that gauge is going to set. The gauge cluster is going to set right here in a dash. In fact, I could get it and bring it here and get a picture. Okay, here's how it goes. It's going to be sitting right on this corner here, and be right above his dash. Looking down on it, all we'll see is a hood. It's not going to interfere with any view out of here. Oh, I think it's going to be great. I think you'll be happy with this. I got to weld some ends on it, like I said, and work on finishing it. This is preliminary. Well, how does this look? It'll be pretty when I get it painted. Look at that. It'll set right in there. I held it up in there, and it fits good. Leave the bottom open for airflow so it doesn't get hot in the gauges. They can't be seen anyway. So this is what I got for the finished product here a few hours later. Okay, I come up with a bracket. I'm just getting started here. This is going to go on the angle of the windshield. I'll drill a couple holes in this area here to hold it on. And then I'll weld this to the bottom flat part of the back of this gauge bracket here. That's what I have in mind. We'll see how it works. This is kind of show and tell here. Yeah, look at all the tools it takes to make a little mess like I got. I got to have cutters, power hacksaws, welders, and grinders. And I still don't have near enough tools to do this kind of stuff, but I get by. Looking at the back of this gauge unit, I made a vent cover with some holes. Because it's going to sit in the window, it's probably going to get pretty warm up there. So I made a nice cover and access to the back of the gauges. All you need to do is take the screws out here on the frame wall of the windshield and pull the unit out of there, and then take these screws off in the back to get to the gauges inside if you got to do any maintenance or for putting them together to taking them apart. It covers the whole area. This is the front side, you can see kind of through the back there. Ventilation holes, makes a nice little cover access too. So anyway, I'm pretty well got it cleaned up and painted now, and I'll be good. Finishing up the day here, it's on the 1st of April. I got these gauges mounted in here, all painted, and it's just about ready to go. Tomorrow I'll work on wires, hooking up wires here. Oh, that'll be a little bit tedious, but we gotta do it. I mean, hopefully I can get through it here and get through it in a day. But anyway, that's looking pretty good here. It's gonna sit up there. Let me get another picture. This kind of gives you an idea how it's going to look here. It's going to be all right. Fits right in with the black dash and the gauges here. It should look pretty good over here. Let me think about the view somewhere in there. Well, I finished up the gauges this morning. Got them all mounted in here, and I just turned the lights on here. I wanted you to see this. Oh, are they pretty?